I mean, so what he should have said to the families is, I'm so sorry for what we've done, and we will do better. And the way they're going to do better is they'll hold themselves accountable. Listen, Mark Zuckerberg's worth $140 billion. If he devoted just 10% of that to helping victims, think what it could do for these families. And by the way, if he would actually change his platform and not allow pedophiles and sex predators on there, he could do a service to every family in America. I'll just say this, Sean. He seems to have all the time and attention in the world to censor conservatives. Facebook leapt at the opportunity to censor any questions about COVID, to label people who had COVID vaccine questions as potential terrorists. If you question the Hunter Biden laptop, they shut you down. But yet they can't lift a finger to take sex predators off their platform. I don't buy it.
So that's Senator Josh Hawley. This was a story we started talking about yesterday because they had that hearing that was in the before the Senate Judiciary Committee. And I sent a piece out about that yesterday. Welcome back to the program. Dana Loesch here with you. I'm recovering from the plague. I feel a lot better. Thank you guys so much for your kind words. You guys are super sweethearts. And it's just, it's been so nice. Thank you. I want to have a very, very clinical discussion about this, because yes, he's right and no, he's not. And here's what I mean, because it's so, it gets so technical with the algorithms and then going as a on a user basis. And I say this as somebody who has literally spent 10 years getting kicked around by social media platforms. I've had videos removed, I've been demonetized, I've been banned, suspended. So I kind of have a beef, right? I have every right and every justification to go on the warpath against big tech. But at the same time, I'm also an absolute speech purist, and I also am very anti-big government. Not anti-government, I'm anti-big government. And that's first and foremost. And that's what I want everyone to be careful of. That's the perspective that I want to enter this discussion through, is big government. Because what does big government love to do? It loves to take a problem, and the more tragic, the better. And it likes to exploit it to expand control every time. So let's look at this conversation that they had before the Senate Judiciary, because they were talking about the dangers of online sexploitation and drug use and bullying. And you had these senators, including Hawley, who were demanding that Mark Zuckerberg apologize to the families. Hawley wanted Zuckerberg to pay them compensation. I don't know what for. And these stories, look, there's no sympathy lost here. They're heartbreaking. But my question is, how exactly is it Zuckerberg's fault? So the big thing, and I think this is Holly's strongest point, is he says, okay, well, you know, you can censor conservatives, but you can't lift a finger against the predators. Well, let's, again, and I know, again, I say this as somebody who has every reason to hate big tech. And there are predators all over the internet. If someone is involved in criminality, if Facebook is involved in actively assisting criminality, by all means, drag them to the woodshed. I don't have a problem with it. I don't think anybody else does either. But there is a big difference in algorithmic editing, for the lack of a better way to say it, and then, excuse me, going on a user-by-user basis. Now, Facebook is so big, and I think in the very beginning, it's really, really difficult to police speech before it's made. I mean, it's impossible. When you're looking at Facebook and Instagram and even X, typically something has to be done to, a post has to be made, a statement has to be made, something has to be shared in order for that legal line to be crossed or for that policy line to be crossed and someone acts to suspend that individual. And that's how usually these, you know, you find these people. To say that there is some sort of algorithm editing happening that encourages predation, that's a huge accusation. I'm not saying it doesn't exist. I'm just saying you gotta prove it. We believe as conservatives that you have to provide evidence, right? Just as we don't like red flag laws, I also don't like red flagging everything else. Then by all means, take it to court, press charges. And if it's something of which they're guilty, take them to the woodshed. But that's a big accusation to make. These kinds of platforms, just as it with anything else, they make it easy for predation. And you know the best counter to that? Do you know the best way to kind of push back on the ease of predation through these platforms is parental involvement. It's not big government coming in and doing it. It's parental involvement. If any parent out there allows their kids unfettered access on social media, you're a bad parent. It's irresponsible, it's reckless, and it's dangerous. Bottom line, you wouldn't let your kids hang out, you know, at a bus stop in a drug dealing part of town, would you? Completely unsupervised. You got to look at social media the same way. I also reject the argument that I hear from some folks, and they're always progressives. They get real mad. And they're like, oh, it's easy for you to say. You know, it's, well, why is it easy for me to say? Is there something that sort of, do I have am I better equipped at monitoring my kids than you are? That doesn't make any sense. I don't understand that argument. Monitor your damn kids. Raise your damn kids. That's your job as a parent. It's not the government's job. It's not Daddy Mark Zuckerberg's job. That is the best way to thwart predation, is to be involved and to monitor your kids. Because this is not something that we can trust the government to do. You're going to allow the government to come in and take over the administration of this, the same government that will sooner take your kid away from you for not allowing them to cut off their genitals and quote unquote transition to a different sex. You're going to allow that government to come in and set these requirements, set these expectations, set these regulations. I mean, come on, guys, we gotta look at what we're doing here. Now, yes, absolutely. The, you know, engagement, the censorship of conservatives, that was an algorithmic thing. That I will say with X, it was an algorithmic thing because it's something that Musk has talked about. They said that there are so many layers that it's taken them years to kind of go through all the code and just clean everything up. With Facebook, oh my gosh, I've been targeted on Facebook so many times. I think it's a lot of their administrators, and that in addition to algorithms. But pointing this out is not a defense of the practice. I'm simply saying I think people need to chill before they rush into a situation that allows a godless government that would take your children away from you for not acknowledging their progressive, quote unquote, transitioning to set the parameters for this. That's my whole point. The internet is full of good and bad things, and it's the responsibility of the parents to help their kids navigate it. Blaming third-party services isn't the solution. That's a formula that the left uses. Case in point, after Uvalde, one of the rifles that was used was made by Daniel Defense. Now, they were targeted because their product was murderously used by a dangerous individual with a known record of violence and threats and disturbing behavior. The family that knew, including the reported uncle that drove the teenager to go buy the rifle after he was previously caught doing drive-by BB gun shootings and swinging around dead cats in bags, the family skirted responsibility, but the company did not. They went after Daniel Defense, the anti-gun lobby. So why was a company responsible for a minor illegally using its illegal product? In 2021, you had a racist murderer drive a Ford SUV through a Christmas parade in Waukesha, killing 5 and injuring 48 people. Is Ford responsible for those fatalities? This is my point. We have to be very careful. Now, if you, and it requires this in our republic, bring up the evidence and press the charge that, well, Ford, you know, made this easier because they were involved in this, or they changed the algorithms, or they encouraged this predation. That's an entire issue. That's an entirely different issue. And one, I'm all for, I believe in capital punishment for child predators, so you're not going to find an argument for me. I think it should be public and live streamed and raise money for the victims, too. You're not going to find an argument for me. But I'm just saying, we got to be very, very careful with us. And I think some, and I like, look, I like Josh Hawley. I don't agree with everybody on everything. And I hate it that we live in such a tribal, politically tribal time. And this is what happens when you get these leftist grifters in the right. You everything gets so politically tribal that you cannot have one disagreement, especially on a very important issue that deserves the sharpening of iron in discussion, without being accused of hating the person or whatever. I like Josh Hawley. I mean, he comes from my home state. I just think he went too hard on this, and I think that he's moved by the stories that he's hearing from the families, and that it's kind of altering his perspective here a little bit. We have to be very, very careful in giving big government a foothold. Kids have to have boundaries. They have to have parental oversight. They have to have intervention when needed, not free reign on social media. Because government and corporations are poor parents. Can't have it.